here at the Century Media headquarters on the tail end of our tour with OTEP, The Birthday Massacre, and Beneath the Sky. And behind us, you have the vehicle that has brought us on all of our tours since 2007, and it shows. This is the Blue Hornet that we always tour in. And I think the lifespan is just about over. it started with us attempting to leave Canada and being sent back in for a little bit. Then we finally made it through, so unfortunately we missed some shows, which we really apologize for because we wanted to make those shows and weren't able to. Then finally we got through and we booted our asses from Montreal all the way to Orangevale, California in, you know, one straight trip, which was about 4 days. And that was last week, so we started the tour there, and since then it's been really good. It's been a lot of fun, the other bands are really cool, the crowds are cool. And we also put in many, many thousands of dollars in expenses into this van just since then, which I said was last week.
Immediately before leaving Montreal, we brought the van and trailer and had every fix that we were supposed to get on it possible, fully inspected apparently. And spent a lot of money on that, and so we're like, alright, peace of mind, safe to go, and then the entire rear differential decided to break again after it was already replaced once, and we were smoking down the highway. We knew that smell right away as soon as it came. We're like, that's the differential. It's like, it has this such a unique smell, that burnt oil in that thing.
It smells like someone lighting chips on fire. Disgusting.
So we were told it's illegal to get a secondhand differential in the state of California. So we went somewhere closer to the Mexican border where apparently you can get a secondhand differential, and
still illegal, but they'll just do it anyway.
They'll do it anyway. So we had to go on the risk of paying less money, but it's
God bless Mexico.
Fingers crossed, fingers crossed.
I'm glad to move Paris from the Agonist. Really enjoyed myself here. Glad to be on tour with those guys. We're all great people, and my dream, man.
Amazing guitar player, amazing beard. What else
can I
say?
All you need to know.
Watch out for the third album. Lots of technical guitar,
beard work.
Well, for him, actually, it was kind of cool because when we first decided to go from being a 4-piece to a 5-piece, I don't remember exactly how, but somehow he got in touch with me on MySpace or something. You know, saying that he was an available guitar player, and I was like, okay, cool. But then we ended up getting Tapley, who's now in the Human Abstract, for that tour. And because he lived a little bit kind of far, I mean, he lives like 2 hours away from us, but it's not a huge deal. But anyways, and so then when we no longer needed a guitar player and our buddies in the Plasma Rifle needed a guitar player, I was like, hey, you should take this guy, Paco, he's really good. So they ended up taking him on. And then they sort of disappeared and went nowhere, and then we needed a guitar player again, so I was like, wait! And so then I contacted the guys from the Plasma Rifle, and I was like, do you still have that guy's number? Because we need him now. And
oh,
so then we kind of ended up taking him back, and it's been really cool. Working on, we have about 8 songs, you know, in the process of being written for the new album. It's well on its way. We aren't playing any new songs per se, but we do have some new additions to the set. That you can see that we've never played before, so it's a different set for sure. What we can see so far is that OTEP fans are digging us, which is super, super cool, because that's definitely a unique type of fan, and there's a lot of, you know, respect going on in that scene, just basically, you know, all the heaviness and, you know, aggression that you would like to see in OTEP, mixed with, you know, some melody and some more sort of technical instrumentation and
intense live performance.
Yeah,
lots of rocking out. We like to have fun on stage.
Yeah,
and we're a metal band, but we like to be on stage like a hardcore band. But we're still music's metal.
That actually is one of the coolest parts about touring, is meeting all the fans, and they've all got something cool to say, or like they've all got their own opinion about us. So it's great to hear their feedback and to meet these people.
Different stories, different kinds of people. You meet people who are soldiers that serve in, you know, Afghanistan and all these things. People that are all kinds of walks of life. You get to learn about different people, and we always like meeting new people. It's a lot of fun.
People came from 6-7 hours away.
So keep coming to the merch booth.
Yeah, come to our shows if we're anywhere in your area. Come see us. We live to play for our fans, and it's always cool to meet you guys at the merch table afterwards. We're all there to sign, take pictures, hang out with you guys, whatever you need. So come and enjoy our show, because that makes it more fun for us.
And make sure to get there early, because we're on first, so.
Yeah, that's right. We have a couple other sort of tour ideas in the works. We're slowly announcing more and more tour dates that you can check online on our official MySpace or official Facebook to get the dates on that. We have plans for South America coming up pretty soon, and then we also have plans for Europe, including a festival in Belgium, the Metal Female Voices Festival. And then we're also looking at some more touring after that, but all along the way we're also writing our third album, so that we'll be prepared for a release next year. So far it's really, really good.
When it comes to listening to music in the van, it's which you might find with a lot of bands, the metal bands, is really unexpected. It's like, oftentimes you're listening to pop music, punk music, rock, blues, metal, hardcore, everything, like, depending on what the mood is. Me and Paco were driving the other night at 4 in the morning, blasting Lady Gaga the whole way. Fucking grooving in our seats.
I quit
for that. I'm glad I was asleep.
You have to do something to make, you know, to make yourself kind of laugh or be interested or something.
Well, the problem really, and we all know, is that metal music that can compete with the sound of a dying engine in a van that's going super loud while you're rolling down the highway. So, I mean, all you hear is like a little bit of snare and yeah, and that's it. And you don't hear guitars, you don't hear anything else. So that's probably why we tend to lean more towards rock and stuff like that, because you can at least hear it through the crappy speaker.
And also, after you play a show and it's, you know, it's loud and everyone's drunk and screaming in your ear all night, you don't want to listen to fucking bass shredding metal.
Yeah.
You want to listen to like classical or something, you know, like winding down. I try to get these guys to listen to like Marduk or Immortal, but in that band, all it sounds like is. Which is kind of already what it sounds like. A lot worse. Baseball bats, spike clubs, grenades, TNT, anything really. World is your input.
Good. Yeah,
send
us
your input.
Yeah,
samurai swords.
Oh,
how can we destroy this band? Yeah.
So this is the last time we'll see this
the
on
last
the road.
Straw.
I think so. I think unless we get really, really desperate, but I don't.
You think we could procure a flamethrower?
Let's make one.
We'll make a flamethrower.
Yeah.
Out of aerosol cans and lighters.
So we'll see a YouTube video soon of this thing being demolished.
I think so. Unless, yeah. We're gonna, cause this thing, it's demolished our spirits enough that we should demolish it.